Hey everyone, welcome back to another Mining Chamber video. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to BIOS mod your RX 580 card. I will be showing you two methods to do that, and this will help you if you're having around 22 to 26 mega hash on your Polaris cards. This will help you get around 30 mega hash, and this guide will work with any 400 or 500 series GPUs. So now let's get into the guide right after the intro. To BIOS mod your Polaris cards, you have two different methods that you can use. The first one is the temporary method, and that is through using command line arguments for changing your memory timings. So that will be the first method that we will cover, and that method will be good if you're using it on your gaming PC and you don't want to permanently BIOS mod your GPU. You can just use this method and it will work fine for you, although the performance won't be as good as using the second method. And that second method being through the Polaris BIOS editor, and that will be a permanent BIOS mod. Both of these methods are very simple to do, and they won't take that much time. For the second method, I'll show you how to do it on Windows 10 as well as on HiveOS or any Linux-based mining operating system. And then for the first method, you can follow the same instructions on Windows 10 or any Linux-based mining operating system and it will be completely fine. So now let's go ahead and get started with the first method. So here in this rig, I have one RX 580 plugged in, and as you guys can see, I already have some overclocks put in. So I have 1130 for the core clock and then 850 for the core voltage, and all these overclock settings can be found on miningchamber.com. I just did reduce the core clock just a little bit because this card is not stable at 1150. So the first step you want to do is you want to go ahead and open up your start miner bat file, or if you guys have no idea how Phoenix miner works, then I recommend checking out the video I've recently released on Phoenix miner. We talked about different command line arguments and what they do. So the two important commands that you want to keep in mind when you're running your Polaris cards are -mt and as well as -rxboost20. So the -rxboost20 will help you achieve a little bit more hash rate, and then the -mt, this is basically BIOS modding your card without having to actually BIOS mod them. So when you run this miner, it will only change the memory timings temporarily, and then when you turn it off, it will go back to default. So now one thing that's very interesting is if you guys check in the Radeon settings, you'll notice here you also have memory timings in the Radeon settings, and you have memory timing level 1 and level 2. And in Phoenix miner, they have option number 1 and option number 2. So if you do option number 1 or option 2, it will automatically change in your memory timings for your Radeon settings. So now since the RX 580 that I have running has a Hynix memory type, I will be running memory timings number 2 because that worked better for me. But before I go ahead and run the memory timings and the RX boost, I am just going to go ahead and get rid of both of these commands and run it without the memory timings or the RX boost so you guys can see how much hash rate I'm currently getting. So as you guys can see here, we are getting around 19 mega hash on Phoenix miner. This is just with the overclock, so we don't have anything else in there. And then what that's telling me is that I definitely need to BIOS mod this GPU so I can have the full potential, which is an additional 10 mega hash or 11 mega hash on this card. So now I'm going to go ahead and close the miner, and then we can try it with the memory timings. So what I need to do here is just add these back. You have memory timings 2 and then RX boost 20, and just save your file and always make sure you run your miner as an administrator, because if you don't run it as an administrator, you won't be able to change your memory timings or your RX boost, and plus it will give you less issues along the way, so just make sure you run it as an administrator. Now before I also run it, I want you guys to notice the memory timings here on the right side for the Radeon settings. So as soon as I run my miner, it will change the timings right away. As you can see here, set VMEM timing to level 2, and then you can see on the right side for the Radeon settings, your memory timing level was set to 2. So what that means is you guys don't need to put it from the command line arguments. Instead, you can do it from the memory timing level on the Radeon settings itself. So now let's go ahead and give the GPU some time to tune, and then after it tunes, it should be around 28 to 29 mega hash. So now that it just finished tuning, you guys can see here that it did find the best GT value. So this is the auto-tune value and it says 61. So what that means is now I can go ahead and close this miner, and then instead of have it auto-tune and take forever to do that, I can just put here GT 61. So now the next time I run Phoenix miner with this GPU, it will automatically run it on GT 61. So now that it's ran with the GT value, it doesn't take forever to auto-tune and it's right away at 28 to 29 mega hash. Now with this method of modifying your BIOS, I was not able to get the card to 30 mega hash, but with the other method that we will try, which is the Polaris BIOS editor, you should be able to get it to 30 mega hash. This one is just a quick fix if you're, for example, using this GPU on your main PC and you don't want to change your BIOS at all. You can just do this instead and you'll be fine with just 29 mega hash rather than 30. You can also try to play around with the overclocks a little bit like I did here, but it still didn't take me that far. Just be careful when you're messing with the overclock settings. For example, when I had this GPU run on 1150 core clock, it was taking around 200 watts off of the wall with the entire system, and just the GPU was taking around 170 watts. So you don't want to push the core clock too much, and when I put it back down to 1130, it started taking only 170 watts off the wall for the entire system, and then for the GPU only it was 140 watts because the system takes around 30 watts idle. So changing the core clock too much will end up causing you to draw a lot way more power than you should be drawing, because your GPU is not going to be able to support it with just 850 undervolt, because your GPU undervolt will not be able to support the core clock you want to put in it. And also your memory type does play a role in this, so if you have a different memory type like Samsung or Micron, then you might have different flexibility into your overclock settings, or you might be stricter on them, so just keep that in mind as well. So that is it for temporarily modifying your BIOS. Now let's go ahead and get started with modifying your BIOS with Polaris BIOS Editor. So the first thing you need to do for this method is you have to install three different applications that we're going to use. The first one being AMD VB Flash, and that's what's going to flash the modded BIOS on your GPU. And then the second thing you want to install is Polaris BIOS Editor, and that's what's going to modify your BIOS by just one click, and it won't take that much effort at all. And then the last thing you need to install is Tech Power Up GPU Z. You're going to use this to save your original BIOS. You can also use ATI Flash to save your original BIOS, but it will be easier through this way. And then optionally there's also the patcher. The patcher is good if your card ends up giving you a code 43 after modding it, and then you can just run the patcher and then it will refresh the card and it will be all set. So if you do get a code 43, then come back to this video, install the patcher from the descriptions below, and then you'll be all good to go. So the links for all these applications will also be in the descriptions below. So now once you install all the three applications that I mentioned in this video, you should have something like this: Polaris BIOS Editor, Tech Power Up GPU Z, and as well as the ATI Flash folder. So the first step in this process is go ahead and open up your Tech Power Up GPU Z. And once you have your Tech Power Up GPU Z opened, you guys will be able to find here your GPUs. So if you have one graphic card plugged in, you'll only see one here. And I honestly do recommend doing it one at a time, unless you're doing it on HiveOS or a Linux-based mining operating system. But if you're doing this on a Windows 10 system, then do one GPU at a time so you don't mix between the different BIOSes, and then you'll end up running into a lot more issues like that. I will show you guys later on how to do it in HiveOS. It's much easier to just download the BIOS from there and modify them on your system, and then upload the BIOS back to HiveOS. So now in Windows 10, we're doing it here with just one GPU like I mentioned, and the first thing you want to do in GPU Z is you want to go ahead and click on this icon right here, and what that does is save your BIOS on your system. So just do save to file, and then you guys can pick wherever you want to save it. So I've already saved this BIOS on my system, and as you guys can see here, I've named it RX 580 Hynix and 20 mega hash. That's because that's how much hash rate I'm getting on this GPU. Now for you, if you bought these GPUs new, you can put your serial number of this card here so you know which BIOS belongs to which card. But for me, since I only have one card that I need to BIOS mod, I don't need to worry about mixing the BIOS or anything like that. But if you have more than one GPU, then make sure that you put something that can be distinctive between every card. You can even just put a number on the card itself with a marker and then name the BIOS based on that number. And also the memory type, you guys can find your memory type here. So it says Hynix GDDR5. Now that's the biggest difference between different cards. So if you have even the same RX 580s, one might have a different memory type than the other, and that does impact your performance as well. So just make sure that you save your BIOS, and in this case I've saved it into the ATI Flash folder. You guys can save it wherever you want, but to have the process easier, just put it in your ATI Flash folder for now until you finish the BIOS modding, and then you can take it out of there. So after you have your BIOS saved, the second thing you want to do is you want to go ahead and open up Polaris BIOS Editor. So go ahead and double left click on that. It will ask you if you want to copy something to clipboard, just say no, and then you'll get to this screen right here. And now you just need to go ahead and open the BIOS, the one that you just saved. So if I go back to desktop and then the ATI Flash folder, I'll find my BIOS right there, and then just open that into the Polaris BIOS Editor. You guys will see multiple different things here. You don't need to worry about any of this. All you need to do in this screen is just click on one click timing patch, and then just hit yes on whatever it shows you, and after that it will automatically apply the patches for you. So as it says here, Hynix memory found at index number 2, now applying universal Hynix mining timings. And then after after that, your BIOS is modded, and that's all you need to do. So now the third step would just be saving your BIOS mod, and then you can just rename the one that you currently have saved, the stock BIOS, just add the mod to it at the end. You can name it whatever you want, but just like I said, make sure that you know which BIOS belongs to which card, and always make sure that you keep the original BIOS. If anything happens wrong, or if you ever want to sell your card or give it to someone, you can just flash that original BIOS back onto the card. So now let's go ahead and save that modded BIOS, and then after we save it, we can go ahead and close the Polaris BIOS editor. And now the fourth step, which is the last step, you just want to go ahead and open up command prompt as an administrator. So run a command prompt as an administrator, and then after you do that, go to your ATI flash folder, and then just right click on the AMD vbflash.exe, go to properties, and then copy the location for that file. So now after you copy the location to your AMD vbflash, go back to your command prompt and type in cd, which is change directory, and then paste in the path that you just copied. So now if I hit enter, it will take me to that path where I have ATI flash and then all the flashing tools as well as the BIOS in there. Now that I'm in the ATI flash folder, all you need to do is type out AMD vbflash and then dash i, and that will show you your GPU that's plugged in. So here it shows that on adapter number 0 I have a Polaris card plugged in, and then the ROM size as well as the test pass. So if everything for you looks normal here, then you're good. Your GPU is plugged in and everything is showing properly, and you know that your card is on index number 0. And now you want to refer to that index by saying AMD vbflash dash p, which is for flashing, and then you select the index, which is 0, and then after that you select the ROM file that you want to flash on your card. So in our case, we have the RX 580 Hynix 20 mega hash mod. So what I need to do is type out RX, and then you guys can hit tab and it will automatically autofill. So whatever name you have in, it will just autofill the closest thing to what you typed out. But you can also just type it out fully without hitting tab. So I can just say 580 Hynix and then the 20 mega hash and all the rest of the title. So after typing out your BIOS file or hitting tab to autofill, you can just go ahead and hit enter. And then after that, you guys will see here, it will flash the card and it will say it's successful, and then it will ask you to restart your computer. And just make sure that when you're doing this step that you're actually flashing the modded BIOS. So if you do the stock ROM instead of the modded ROM, then you won't see any difference. So just make sure that you do flash the proper BIOS onto your GPU, the one that's modded. To avoid any mistakes, you can feel free to move the stock BIOS into a different folder, and then you can just keep the modded BIOS in here. So just make sure that you have it flashed, and then after that, when you see the restart system to complete vBIOS update, then you know that you've done it successfully. So now I'm going to go ahead and restart the system, and then we can see how much hash rate we're going to get with the modded BIOS. So now I went ahead and restarted the rig, and the BIOS mod is complete. So what that means is I can go ahead and run Phoenix Miner or any mining software without putting any parameters, and then I should be getting around 30 mega hash instead of 20 mega hash. So if I go ahead and edit my Phoenix Miner bat, you guys can see here all I have is just dash RX boost 20. This is recommended to have whether you BIOS mod your card or not. So now before I run my Phoenix Miner script, I first need to set my overclocks again, because after BIOS modding your card, your overclocks will reset. So as you guys can see here, the voltage is at all the way at 1150 and the memory is not set properly. And what I did is I saved the profile for my overclocks from before, so I'm just going to go ahead and load my overclocks, and then from there it's all ready. So you guys can save your profile as well just by hitting save profile, and then after that you can just load them every time without having to change every value by itself. So now, like I mentioned before, this card was having troubles at 1150 core clock, so I'm going to do 1130 core clock. That doesn't mean it will apply for your scenario as well. You can try 1150, and if you're drawing way too much power, then you can try 1130 instead. And then my memory clock is at 2150, so it's the exact same overclocks that I had running with the memory timings. And now I can go ahead and apply changes and go back to my Phoenix Miner and run my Phoenix Miner as an administrator. So now let's go ahead and give it some time so that it tunes up, and then it shows us how much hash rate we should be getting. So as you guys can see here, we're getting around 31 mega hash from Phoenix Miner with the BIOS mod. So it's a lot better than we first started, which was around 20 mega hash. So that is basically free 10 mega hash that you can get with your Polaris card without having to do much work. And no, BIOS modding does not hurt your card. It won't kill your card at all. Actually, the power draw is basically the same as we started. And if you guys want to learn more about BIOS modding or overclocking in general, there's different GPU overview articles that we have on miningchamber.com, as well as a full video that I've done about overclocking in BIOS modding and how they affect your GPU. And just remember, you can use the same exact steps for your Polaris cards, whether you have RX 480, 470 or 570s, and you're most likely also going to be able to use this on the 590s, but the overclocks might differ slightly. So if you want to run the overclocks, try to just tune down the settings a little bit and see if it works with you. Eventually I will be able to have all the overclocks on miningchamber.com, so you guys can just bookmark the website, then you'll find different settings coming out very frequently in the Mining Chamber articles. Now, to BIOS mod your GPUs on HiveOS, you can do it much easier. So what you need to do is you can just have your rig running. For example, here I have four different RX 580s, and then you guys can see three of them are modded, and then the third one does not need modding. It's just the riser is kind of busted, so I might need to fix that, and then it should be running fine. Now, to mod your GPUs in HiveOS, you first want to access the cards list here. Now, after you access your cards list, I'm going to go ahead and select the RX 580s, so I only get the RX 580s here. And then you guys now can see all the different RX 580s I have in different mining rigs. So all you need to do when you get to this page, you just need to go ahead and download the vBIOS, so that's your GPU BIOS. And then after you download it, you can save this BIOS on your HiveOS storage, which I recommend doing so you can have a backup there. And then you can also download it to your system. So after you download it to your system, you can follow the exact same steps, whether it's on your personal computer or anywhere that you want to do it. And then just run this BIOS through the Polaris BIOS editor and everything like that. And then you can go ahead to your vBIOS ROM storage, and then you can do add BIOS, and you can choose the file that you modded and upload that modded BIOS to your HiveOS account. And after that, you can just go back to your cards, and then from your cards, do select vBIOS and then select the modded BIOS. So as you guys can see here, I only have the 5700 XT gigabyte mod BIOS, but in your case, you'll have multiple different ones for the RX 580s. And then you'll also have your original BIOS for every card saved to your vBIOS ROM storage. Now, the benefits of doing it that way is you don't have to do it one card at a time. Instead, you can just download the BIOS of every card on your HiveOS account, and then from there you can just modify them one by one. Again, just make sure that you save the original BIOS and save it in a way that's distinctive between every card, so you know which card belongs to which. At least even mention the memory type on the cards. So here I have all Samsung memory types, so just keep that in mind, and then hopefully you should be good to go with HiveOS. So that will be it for the video, guys. I hope this video helped you out and you were able to get an additional 10 mega hash on your GPUs. If you have any questions or any feedback, please feel free to leave it in the comments below. And if you enjoyed the video, please make sure to hit the thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed, make sure to subscribe. I will be releasing videos more frequently that can benefit you. So thank you guys again, and I hope you have a wonderful day.